Welcome back to the channel. This is Never Too Old to Rock. I'm your host, Jim. You can call me Jim. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're already a subscriber, then you know what you are. Do I need to tell you? Do I? You're fucking awesome. And you're more than awesome. You're fucking amazing. If you've just clicked onto the channel and you don't know what it's about, and you haven't bothered to read the description, it's okay. I'm not going to blame you. You know, these things happen. But I'm going to tell you what it's about. It's reactions to rock and roll, rock, metal, anything in between that's got a bit of a kick to it, you know. And some 80s music. Now you're probably thinking, why the 80s music? What's wrong with you? Because I'm 46 years of age. The best time for music was the 80s. Music these days is, well, how can I put this? I don't want to offend all the youngsters out there. So how can I put this politely? It's fucking awful. It fucking big pile of shit. It really is. Sorry, but it is. There's no life to it. There's no fucking energy to it. It's just, it all sounds the same. It does. At least back in the 80s and, early to mid 90s, it was good. But no. No. And there was some really good stuff in the 80s. I enjoyed the 80s. You know, it brings back fond memories of when I was a kid. You know, getting away with fucking murder, having some great tracks on the radio and having fun. It's when, even in the days when kids could have fun, you know, and I enjoyed that. So that's why I put in anyway. It's a request from Sandro Maldini. Welcome. Good on you for joining us. Yes, it's Guns N' Roses. Ain't It Fun? This was on the Spaghetti Incident album, which was a cover of punk tracks that they used to listen. Guns N' Roses used to listen to as they were growing up. I thought it was a great album. Yeah. I did. I think their cover versions of all the tracks on there. Yeah, they did them justice. I think my favourite song on that album was Hair of the Dog. I just like the way that they performed it. It was a good song. It's one of my favourites from that album. And this is another one that's one of my favourites. Ain't It Fun? Here we go. It's fun. Yes. Let's enjoy it. Have a good one. Let's do this.
Thank you.
Between the ages of 18 to 23, I was so fucked up. I really was. I was a fucking mess, and I thought that I was going to die young. I was very self-destructive. I was a fucking idiot. I admit it, I was. Just getting into trouble with the old Bill. That's what we call the police. The old Bill. I was just fucked. Everything wasn't going right. The only thing I had was drinking and whatever I could get my hands on. Was a fucking mess. And I freely admit that. And then for some reason, I hit 23 and I figured there's got to be more to this. All I can say is, when there comes a point in your life, and if you think it hasn't hit you yet, don't worry, it's only around the corner. It will hit you. It'll hit you straight between the eyes. You won't even see it coming. Well, you've got to realise that yeah, it's fun at the time. Because you don't know any better. And back then I didn't know any better. I freely admit it. Now, I'm 46. I changed my life. I got cash in the bank. How can I say? I'm comfortable for what I've got. I'll put it that way. I'm comfortable. And it takes some, 'cause back then, all the pressure that people were putting on me, I couldn't handle it. But now that I changed, I did changed my life. I've got my act together. Last time I had a drink was probably last year, around Christmas time. Was probably the last time I had a drink. I've just worked out what's important to me. And I feel so much better for it. I do. I'm only saying this because when they use the line, ain't it fun when you know that you're going to die young? At the time, I freely admit that I didn't care. And we're going back to the very early 90s, about 93, 90. Yeah. I was fucked. I'm just glad that I woke up and got my life in order, and now I am, like I said, I'm comfortable. Don't really have to worry about money. I still have to pay my bills and that. Of course, naturally, everyone has to. But when this lockdown is, or when this COVID shit is over, I'm still going to be comfortable, and I'm happy with that. But I do understand the phrase, "Ain't it fun when you're going to die young?" When you know that you're going to die young, I should say. Because when it hits you, fucking hell, it will hit you. And you have to make them changes. Back then, I didn't really care. But I've worked too hard and too long to make things better for myself and throw it all away, and I'm not going to do that. But I do understand them words, especially. Take it as you what you want, but I do understand. Don't do what I did, which was, don't go around thinking that the world owes you something, because it doesn't. The world doesn't owe you anything. The world didn't put you here. It's your mum and dad. They put you here. You have to put in order to get something out of life. And it took me a while to figure that out. But I'm glad I did. So, Sandro Maldini, I hope you enjoyed the video. Told you I would do it. I always keep my promises. And that's one thing that I hold very dear to me, is my word. I think it's the second Guns N' Roses request I've had today, so keep them up. I like Guns N' Roses. So, yeah, that was Guns N' Roses. Ain't It Fun from the Spaghetti Out Incident, which came out in 93, I think. Yeah, 1993. So, yeah, hope you enjoyed it, and I shall catch you all. Oh, before I say anything, don't forget, like the video, subscribe, please check out my other videos. They're all there on my page. Just go to my name underneath the description. Well, just above the description, it will come up and there'll be a list of videos on there. So check them out, and I shall catch you all in the next one. Peace.